Greetings, naturopath from New Zealand, Eric Bakker here, author of Candida Crusher. Thank you for checking out my video. Today we're going to look at the difference between a prebiotic and a probiotic. So what are they and what differences are there between them? So prebiotics is some real fad that I think we've just really taken in the dietary supplement industry, probably in the last 5 years more so. So prebiotics are thought of as a beneficial sugars that help to feed up the probiotic bacteria. So it's like food for probiotics, giving them food. When you think about it, it's a pretty dumb idea, because shouldn't you be eating food that either contain these beneficial bacteria or help stimulate their production, rather than eating food that feeds bacteria? It just doesn't make sense to me. Well, saying that, I did work with prebiotics for at least 2 or 3 years in my clinic with many different patients. And I found some interesting effects with a lot of different people. In the end, about probably a year ago, I decided to stop using them because I realized they were giving me more problems, than solving problems. They were causing actually problems with people. And I was routinely getting feedback from people on these products long term with things like brain fog, bloating, gas, still can't tolerate many different kinds of foods, bowel problems not really resolving, in spite of all the diet changes that we recommended and lifestyle changes. We still found people having like bowel problems. So I got rid of these, basically. I don't really use them much anymore, if at all. And I find that people respond much better to just a general probiotic. So probiotics are beneficial bacteria. Prebiotics are, supposedly food for the beneficial bacteria. When it comes to beneficial bacteria, make sure that the supplement contains lactobacillus acidophilus and bifidobacterium, okay? So bifidobacterium is very important for your supplement to have for the colon, for the large intestine, the lactoacidophilus for the small intestine. And I like a few different strains in a good probiotic, particularly the lactorhamnosus. I like the lactorhamnosus, lactoplantarum. I like those two strains because they have quite specific effects on the immune system. Those combined with the lactoacidophilus and then the bifidobacterium, a couple of strains of bifido, you've got a very nice quality probiotic, and that should work quite well in your body. Take them with food, okay? So you can take them with food or without food, but I'll do a whole video in general on that alone. But what I want you to do probably initially is to take them with food, one or two per day. Thanks for tuning into my video.